check out this Fox. It's an automatic convertible car, so definitely a cruiser. It's in good shape though, it's nice. I can't see much rust, if any, on the thing, actually, none, which is cool. But yeah, it's a Vortec. It's got a V2T1 on it, according to the tag there. Again, non-intercooled, 93 octane, a little bit of race gas mixed in just from the smell, which could be, you know, it seems like damn near a drop of it will make it smell that way. But your typical stuff, you know, headers, exhaust system. It is, like, again, through an automatic. It does have a converter in it. We'll see what the converter stalls at. Hoping to make better than, you know, better than 460. Be cool to see 5. We'll see what we can make with it. Again, this thing's a nice car. Leather seats are nice. They're in good shape. Yeah. Definitely a cool cruiser. Anyway, I'm going to dive into this thing, get the drivability stuff sorted out, and see what kind of power we can make. Well, 428. I don't really trust that torque value. I'll show you why in a second. 399 horsepower. If you check the curve out, you see the hit here. That's basically the converter flash. Just the inertia of the engine running into the converter stall speed will give us that spike there. You can see how the graph falls. Now, this is only 6,000 RPM up here. And you see how it's falling all the time. That is very not like a centrifugal car. And the reason is we're seeing a significant amount of belt slip. When I first lay into it, it's making about 10 pounds, 9 to 10 pounds. By the end of the 6,000 hit, it was all the way down to 4. So we definitely got to get the belt slip issue sorted out. Another thing, in the video you saw a bunch of smoke. I'll show you guys something. An open element breather in this environment is not good. What happens is it's dripping radon. Number one header tube down, well, not number one, number five header tube down there. Small block forward firing order, right? Or cylinder numbering pattern anyway. That's what all the smoke was about. Only made 2 hits with it. First hit was just kind of a see what's going on. It's in the ballpark feeling wise. Next hit was put a little bit of timing in it, see if it helps. But the belt slip is just a problem. We're gonna have to sort that out. He had talked before about putting a cog drive on it, and I believe that will be his plan. I've always liked these BBK manifolds. It'd be cool to see if somebody else on YouTube's done a test on those. I haven't seen one, but I haven't looked for one either, so there might be one out there. They're a neat looking piece nonetheless. That's it for this thing. I'm gonna get it off of here and move on to the next project.